Are you getting a bruise on your pubic bone or on your thighs in snatch and clean? In today's video, we're going to look at what's going on there and show you exactly how to fix it. Hey there, it's Drew Dillon from Project Lift, and in this week's video, we're looking at saving your pubic bone, the bruises that happen at the hip, at the thighs, and we're going to dig into what's going on and we're going to show you exactly how to fix it. Now, I've broken today's video down into three areas: why this is happening, when this is happening, and how in the world to fix it. So let's go ahead and dive in. But before I get to it, if you're watching this video, I imagine you want to get better at your Olympic lifts. So I encourage you, check out our free guide on how to improve the Olympic lifts now. It'll give you tips, quick fixes. You're really going to enjoy it. If this video helps you, make sure you subscribe. There's more coming each week, but most importantly, pay it forward and share it with a friend that it could support. Why is a bruise at the hip happening? Let's look at this. I got three things for you. One, it's the bar's too far away. Two, you're wanting to slam your hip forward as you drive. You're pushing that hip forward. And three, you're pulling the bar in with your back. So all of these we could look at and say have a component of technique to it. But at times there's components of strength as well. The first one, when we look at the bar being too far away, this could either be because you're incorrectly tightening your back. So your back's not set as it should be, which lets the bar get away from us. So once it gets to the hip, there's this big gap between us and we go to drive and there's just more of a collision than driving through the bar in a good way. The second one, when we look at driving that hip forward, I see this a lot when athletes want to try to make the bar make noise, or they're trying to get their hip onto it. And what comes out is they're sending their force forward versus driving through those legs into the ground to drive their hip up. So again, we're taking the energy and we're directing it into the bar horizontally, which doesn't help our lift and just bruises our hip. And then when we look at that third one, when we look at pulling the bar into us, this is something that you see all the time because of the cue, keep the bar close, keep the bar close, keep the bar close. And by doing that, figuring out strategies of how to keep the bar close, we come up with incorrect strategies that actually make us pull the bar into our hip, which if you think about it, our goal from the floor all the way overhead is acceleration vertically. Right? We want this bar to move up and this vertical path as we're coming up from the floor. If there's a component where our back's tightening and actually pulling the bar horizontally, we are taking a lot of power and a lot of energy out of this lift, let alone bruising our hip. So I wanted to run through those because if one of those cues or one of those mindsets is sounding familiar, this could be an opportunity to explain what's going on with why your hip is bruising. When does this happen? When does the bruise at the hip happen? And really, I got two things for you here. When we're new to the sport and when we're tired. So when you look at when we're new, bruising the hip, unfortunately, is a pretty common part of the learning curve. We're understanding how to keep our back tight. We're understanding how to drive into the bar vertically. We're understanding how to keep our back set as we move through the movement versus trying to pull the bar in. And all of these components, as we're trying to figure out what muscles are active and what muscles are relaxed, then inevitably we're going to bruise the hip at times. So that's completely normal. Now, number two, when we start to get tired, this, let's use just tired as a general term, as our nervous system starts to break down, doesn't have to be, I'm sleepy fatigued. It's when the nervous system is fried, and this can come from stress, poor eating, poor sleep. You may not feel overly tired, but if you're just not moving well, things aren't clicking. That's when we know it's more of a nervous system thing. Is, we've lifted well before, we're thinking all the same things, and we're just not able to perform like we typically perform. That's much more nervous system. And as we start to break down in that way, we're setting ourselves up, if we're still in that learning progression, but even for seasoned veteran athletes, for the bar to get away from us, create a collision, and get a bruise on that hip. So if you are new to this, bear with me. You're in the process. This is going to get better. And two, if you're just getting fried, time to admit it to yourself. Step back, move on to the next exercise, or go home and rest. How do we fix the bruise on the hip. So here's the thing, guys. The first one I got for you in this section here, you're not gonna like. It's to rest it. It's to move on. If you've gotten a bruise and you're finding that you're wanting to move your hands on the bar, you're finding that you're wanting to change your movement, trying not to let the bar hit that bruise, we're training poor technique. This is not a time to train. This is a time to rest, move on, let it heal, come back and continue training. Now, when we look at what can we do, what drills do we have, when we come back after this is healed up, continue training as we were, it really highlights how we're warming up. What technical technique drills are we using to understand back tightness and everything else that we're doing? And one of my favorites are the pull version of the lift. You look at snatch pull, you look at the clean pull, and it really allows us to break down everything that's going into the hip, how we're moving from the floor, how we're staying set, and are we still in a position to punch without worrying about changing direction, receiving the bar, any of that. So they can be great exercises from any position, above the knee, below the knee, from the floor, so you can attack this from a variety of different ways. And if you're really having trouble with how you're moving at the hip, start above the knee off boxes. If you're doing pretty good at the hip, but this is still an issue, you can move from the floor as you work these technique drills. Now, I'm curious, who would be interested in a video on how to do a pull, snatch and clean? I see a lot of athletes who have never been taught well with that, and what they're doing is not applying to the lift at all. It looks completely different, which is stupid and silly at the same time, right? So if you're interested in that, leave a comment below that you are, and we'll put it on the list. So until next time, guys, good luck. Hope the hip's feeling better, and we'll see you next week.